I went to see a movie today called Bad Grandpa. Bad Grandpa reminded me of you.
Thank you very much.
So, Jackass present another film after years of making us laugh, maybe 10, 15 years now. They've brought out a film, Bad Grandpa, the character that we have seen from time to time in their television series before. And look, I feel silly reviewing this film because it's all in the name of fun and it's all laughs. It's not really about story or anything like that. It's just, can you make us laugh? And they made me fucking laugh. It was great fun. I had a great time. It was brilliant. I was doubting it before I went in. I thought, well, they're just focusing on one character now, maybe it's not going to be so funny. I needn't have worried. So I mean, just to sum it up briefly, Johnny Knoxville plays I've forgotten the guy's name, what they call the grandpa, it's not really important, but Johnny Knoxville plays the character and he's not recognizable throughout the whole movie. He just stays in character, and basically his wife has died. They get humour out of that. His daughter is a crack addict going to prison. They get humour out of that. His grandson is a little fat kid who no one seems to like. They get humour out of that. And the grandson's dad basically wants nothing to do with the grandson until he realises that he will get $600 a month in welfare for him. So Bad Grandpa has to take his grandson across the country and deliver him to his dad. And of course, along the way, there's a variety of pranks, humorous situations, which for the most part work.
You're gonna fix this penguin.
If I was fixing it, you'd see me fixing it, but did you notice how I wasn't fixing it? Watch out for the penguin, sir.
This thing doesn't work.
Nothing.
I laughed at most of them. They were all really well done in that same sort of style as like Borat was done. However, this one was more believable. In Borat, there's a lot of situations which are obviously meant to be pranks when they're pranking members of the public, where it felt like they were set up or clearly they had to have had some knowledge beforehand. Like, for example, in Borat, that scene where Borat and the fat guys stay at that elderly Jewish couple's house. They had cameras inside their house and whatnot. I just didn't buy it. I didn't believe that. Whereas in this, every prank situation, obviously it did happen. You can believe it. And there's some really, really funny situations throughout it. I'm not going to spoil any of them because you've just got to go and see it. But one of the funniest ones was at this male, it's a ladies' night at a strip club. And these male strippers there, an all black crowd, and then you've got Johnny Knoxville there. So I would suggest that you just go and see it for yourself, because it's very, very funny. It really made me laugh. And it was nice, it was nostalgic, you know, because I haven't seen anything from Jackass since the Jackass movie, the 3D movie they did like 3 years ago. I saw it while I was out in Canada. And again, I went to that thinking, well, I don't think I'm going to think this is funny. I always liked Jackass, but I thought, well, the movies, they try too hard. No, it's just great. It's just more of the same, really. And so, yeah, there's story in this. The story is a bit more believable as well. It's got quite a nice heart to it. It's just the situations are funny, man. They are funny. And it's just go and see it. Go and see it if you want to have a bit of a laugh. I can't really give it more of a review than that, really. I can't be analytical or critical. It is quite beautifully shot, to be honest with you. The shots that you get of the country of America as they go on this road trip are brilliant. And well, I won't spoil it too much, but at the end, during the end credits, you get to see a bit like behind the scenes. And two things occurred to me during the movie. One was, I wonder how much involvement there was from the rest of the Jackass crew. I know it says Jackass Presents, but this is just Johnny Knoxville. I wonder how much of the other guys are all involved, like Bam and Spike Jones and whatnot. And you see them all in the end credits and behind the scenes. Fucking bike. Which was nice. And the other thing that you get, which has now just gone out of my mind. Oh yeah, the other thing you get is, throughout the film, I kept thinking, every time they did one of their pranks, public pranks, I kept thinking, I wish I could see these people's reactions once they find out that it's for a movie. Because consistently throughout the movie, it just cuts off at that point where you think, oh, I just want to see how they'd react once they find out this was just a prank. And you get to see all of that in the credits as well, which is great. And the reactions to some of those things are really funny as well.
I had to adjust it a little.
Whoa! What the? What the? What the? What the? What? Stop! Stop! Whoa, stop!
Unplug it!
Oh, my God. What are you trying to do to me?
Jesus, honey.
Oh my God! Oh God! Put it down! Put it down!
It's really good fun. It's good fun. I enjoyed it a lot, and I wasn't expecting to. And you know what's really nice? Right at the very end of the credits, and I was thinking they've got to put the icing on the cake by doing this gesture, and they did. The movie was in honor of Ryan Dunn, the member of the Jackass crew who killed himself. Well, didn't kill himself, but died in a car crash because he'd had too much to drink. So it's good that they put that call out and shout out to him, and it was kind of emotional as well. But anyway, good fun, great fun. I had a good time watching it. Because this review is so short, because I'm not going to analyse and criticise the movie to death, I thought I'd do a few shout outs as well, just to give some love back to some people that I've really enjoyed talking to over the past few weeks since my return to the Tube. First and foremost, always got to be first and foremost because of everything that he's done for me. And just for being a top bloke. I don't want to give him too big a head though, you know. I don't want to give him too big a head. But, well, it's Chris Blue. It's Chris Blue 007. I just got to say thank you to you, man. You were the one person that, for that my year's absence, you were there that I could talk to from time to time as well. And I've just really appreciated you being there. You're a good mate, man. Really good mate. I'm glad that I met you. And I'm glad that we're going to be... hitting the town on Monday and revealing quite a wacky video, I would imagine, to the rest of the Tube next week at some point. So much love to you, man. Although he'll call me gay for saying that. I think he protests too much, that man. That's why he likes Sucker Punch so much, because it makes him out to be very heterosexual. I think he's trying to pull the wool over our eyes, YouTube. So think savvy. But much love to that man. Second of all is Hip Hop and Rap 71. This guy I've only just got to know since I've returned to the Tube, and man, his videos are wicked. They're awesome. He's got a massive steelbook collection, like Chris Blue. He does some great showcases, as he pointed out on that last video that I did. You'd never see the man's face. He's a man of mystery, man of disguise. He's like the Scooby-Doo villain, but you never get to see the mask reveal. We don't want to. We want to keep that mystery. But anyway, go and have a look at his channel. Check out his reviews. He's a top quality guy. He's like a normal geezer. He's a bit of a cockney geezer. I get the impression that he's a bit like a wheeler dealer, a bit of a Del Boy. I might be wrong, and that's not a bad thing either. But I like him. He's a really nice guy, really genuine guy, good to chat to. Give the man some love. Go and check out his channel, Hip Hop and Rap 71. I'll put all the links to these guys below. Third, another someone I met recently in the last couple of weeks is Mr. BP92. Now, I believe this guy is only 14 years old. He's from England as well. All of these people I'm going to recommend actually are from England. Mr. BP92. And it's rare. I was really pleasantly surprised to see someone so young with such a good mind about film and with such an appreciation for really, really good films as well. A la Taxi Driver. I think he said Taxi Driver was like his favourite film or one of his favourite films or something. He does a lot of reviews, but they don't go on for too long. So it's not like one of my videos or one of the other guys' videos where you're like, oh fuck, I've got this buckle in for 15-20 minutes. Go and check out his channel. Really smart guy, really cool guy, nice taste in films. I recommend you go and visit his channel. What lane am I supposed to be in here? This one? No. See, not concentrating. So I best get off this. But I'm going to do one last shout out to someone who definitely needs the love at this point, because he's just starting up. And I remember what it was like when I just started up my channel, and I was thinking, oh fucking hell, nobody's watching my videos, what's the point of this? I'm filming this, I'm going to all this effort, what's the point? Anyway, the guy's name, JustAFreak87, right? This guy, he's been going for about a month or so, and his videos are great. They are really informative. He does like almost like spotlight videos, like he did a 50-minute video on the David Lynch catalog, for example. And he does specific videos on like just analysing one film. Like recently he did Texas Chainsaw Massacre, the recent one, in Midnight Meat Train. And then also he does like haul reviews when he gets like a bunch of Blu-rays and DVDs and whatnot and reviews them all. He's a really cool guy. His style's not too dissimilar to mine either. He's about the same age as me, I would imagine. Give this guy some love. Go and check out his channel and have a look at his reviews, because they're all wicked. All of these guys that I've been talking about are entertaining, really nice people that are cool to chat to as well. So go and check them all out. Guys, I know there's others of you as well, and I'm sorry, I couldn't give a shout out to everyone. I just wanted to give these guys a shout out because these people in particular I've been talking to quite a bit recently, and I've really liked the support that they've given me, and I want to give them some support back as well. So go and check them out. The link is below. Guys, hope you like this video, and I will be seeing you soon when I'm accompanied by Mr. Chris Blue. And I won't tell you what movie we're going to go and see and review, but we're going to do one video on my channel and one video on his channel. I think we're going to be doing the review, the movie review that we go to see on my channel, and our actual day out in London will be up on his channel. So keep your eyes peeled for that. That should be some good fun for you guys. So until then, keep on doing what you're doing. Much love, and I'll see you soon.